Both requirements and requirement documents can be versioned, and some basic information on those versions is available to SOAP users. The other concept is the requirement document tree and how to navigate the tree and add new requirements to it using SOAP. So requirements and requirement documents are the only test track objects with true versioning. Detailed audit information is available for all the other types, but a true snapshot in time is only available from requirements and requirement documents. Requirement documents are versioned manually by creating snapshots. Requirements are automatically versioned by the test track server on the first edit after appearing in any requirement document snapshot. In SOAP, the C snapshot info object represents all of the requirement document snapshots. The create snapshot method creates a new snapshot and uses the C snapshot info object to do that. Both the label and comment on that class are optional. You don't provide a label, one is just assigned by the server. The C version info object is the requirement version object. Since requirement versioning is always handled by the server, the C version info object is purely read-only. As one final note, although the version info for both requirements and requirement documents is viewable, actual previous versions are not viewable through SOAP. The only way to see those is to use the desktop client. The requirement document hierarchy is a tree representing the specification document's outline. So a list of requirements in a document can be fetched using the get requirements IDs for document function. On the flip side, a single requirement may be shared with several requirement documents. The function get document IDs for requirement returns all of the documents containing that requirement. Also, a requirement can be added to a document through SOAP by using the append to requirement document function. The requirement is added to the document under a given parent. Use 0 to indicate that you want to add it under the document root. So the actual requirement document tree is represented with the C document tree node class. This is a new SOAP functionality for the TestTrack 2011 release. The tree node contains the summary, tag, outline number, and record ID of the requirement within the tree. Each node also contains a list of child nodes, and in this way you can use that as a recursive data structure to recreate the entire requirement document hierarchy. The get document tree function returns the hierarchy for any given requirement document. Last, all of the members in the tree are read-only. Requirement document tree management in SOAP is limited to the append to requirement document function that I introduced in the last slide. So in today's final demo, I'm going to be combining a lot of the linking and test track RM concepts to provide some automatic requirement document management. I'll create a post-save executable trigger that fires when I approve a document. So the trigger will create a snapshot of the document and then generate test cases for all of the functional requirements within that document. Those test cases will be linked back to the original requirement and then manually marked as suspect. So looking at my document here, I have a full list, just a big, huge requirement, and it's got a bunch of different types of requirements within here, and I'm only going to be generating test cases for my functional requirements. So that's a subset of everything that's in here. So I have my document management project here, and the starting position is a little bit different than the other ones. Because I'm using a trigger, instead of writing any messages to the console, I'm actually going to write them to the event log, the Windows event log. So I'm going to be redirecting standard out here, redirecting it, writing everything that I capture to the event log. down here. So after I log in right here, I'm getting the record ID of the document that just had the approve event added to it. That's this ID here. Now I want to take a snapshot of that document immediately. So I create a snapshot, set the label just to the time right now, and set a comment, and then create a snapshot. You just pass the snapshot object right to it with the ID of the document you want to create the snapshot on. Now I want to process all the requirements in the document and look for functional requirements to generate test cases for. So for each requirement, I'm getting all the requirement IDs for everything in the document, and then I'm looping through all of the requirement, I'm looping through each ID, getting that requirement, checking its type, or is it a functional requirement? If it is, then I'm going to generate a test case for it. I'm just creating a new test case. I'm setting the summary of the test case equal to the requirement summary, setting the type as requirements, since this is doing requirement testing. And in my steps, I'm actually setting a comment here that has a TT Studio hyperlink back to the original requirement document that this test case came out of. Now I want to also assign this test case to a QA person to actually write the test case data. So I'm creating an assign event here, saying that a new functional requirement has been approved in document, and then the name of the document here. And the user that I'm actually going to assign to is coming out of a custom field on the requirement. I've created a custom field called QA owner, and I'm going to be looking for the QA owner field, pulling out that value and setting that person in the assign list. So in my assign event, assigned to list is actually the value of the QA owner field. Then I'm going to add that assign event to my test case event list. Next, I'm going to save. So I add the test case to the project. It comes back with the record ID for that test case. Now I actually need to link the requirement to the test case. I'm going to create a linked item for the requirement. So I just create a new linked item here. Set the table name is equal to requirement, and the entity ID is equal to my requirement record ID. Now I need to create the linked item for the test case. So it's very similar. I'm creating a new linked item. I set the entity ID equal to the test case's record ID. The table name is test case. And I'm setting that link item as suspect in this case so that the QA owner knows that they need to review that. Now I'm going to add those linked items to an actual link. So I create a new link. I set the link definition name. It's requirement tested by. This is a parent-child link, and the parent is actually the requirement. So I set that as the link parent here. And in my child list, I set the test case that I just generated. Last step is to add that link. I'll go ahead and compile that. Go back to my project here. And I approve this document. And now if I watch my test case list here, over time, I should see the generated test cases start coming in. So there they are. You can see that they're marked as suspect over here. They're assigned to a QA resource. And if I actually view this and go into it, is see that the first step here contains the hyperlink back to the requirement document that it was generated from. If I look at the suspect dependencies here, I see that my test case is marked as suspect, and it was manually marked as suspect, like because we set the link item as suspect instead of using a workflow event. And that went through all of my functional requirements.